like I just did this yesterday. All right, let's go around the other side. Hang our jewelry, they call it. And I like to have the camera out here in case somebody wants to run us over. We got him on camera, right? I'll put it up here. Thank you. push the emergency call number, and it called emergency services. I don't need that. It was a mistake. That's costing me time, dude. All this freaking phone.
Let's go.
Ready scales. I am not going through this anymore. I've spent enough time getting soaking wet.
Thank you.
right, so what we have here is a chain that's a little bit short. And you can see the distance between the cross link here and all the way down here before we see the next one. And it's way too short to come around the edge of the tire here where it's supposed to be, over the shoulder. And chances are good. Well, it might not fall off of there. It's just not gonna like the ride. Such a long slap here, long span right here. And so what I did is I took an old cross link and I just crimped it to the hook and I crimped it up here so it can't fall out, and just to get us down the road. Put four bungees on it to help keep it captured. Let's walk around the other side. I'm just putting one drive on each side and one trailer tire. I don't think anybody's checking, and I don't think it's bad enough to warrant here in March. Temperature is 34 degrees. This stuff is wet, it's not frozen, you can see. It's pretty good. And I have had, this is the third time I'm putting single chains on the drives, a single one on the trailer this winter. And have, knock on wood, I've done well. See, this is what you want. You want this outside chain to be outside the tire on both sides, so it's fully captured. But let's go. We'll do the thing, man. Driver's side is good, man. It's just the passenger side is kind of twisting it. It's a function of when you hang them up, you gotta be, well, you hang them up good. The problem is when you get them off the thing.